Hi, I'm Nina Georgescu, and today I'm going to present our contribution, Abnormal, new benchmark for supervised open-set video anomaly detection. This is a joint work with Andra Axintoaie, Andrei Florescu, Tudor Mare, Paul Șumedrea, Radu Ionescu, Fahad Khan, and Borașa. In the literature, there are two distinct formulations to deal with the difficulty of the video anomaly detection task. The first one is the one-class classification task, where the training videos contain only normal events, while test videos contain both normal and abnormal events. The second formulation is the weakly supervised action recognition task, where training videos contain both normal and abnormal events, but the annotation is provided at the video level. To date, there is no dataset that contains abnormal events in the training set which are disjoint from the test set. This would enable a fair head-to-head comparison between the two formulations. Our contributions are the following. We frame video anomaly detection as a supervised open set task, introducing Abnormal, a new dataset with virtual scenes. We demonstrate that abnormal training videos are useful to existing state-of-the-art models for abnormal event detection. We show that the abnormal benchmark can boost performance of a recent method on two natural scene datasets. In this table, we present the comparison between abnormal and existing video anomaly detection datasets. In the open set paradigm, abnormal has the largest number of anomaly types, scenes, number of abnormal test frames, and anomalies. It is also the only dataset that provides a validation set. Abnormal is generating using the Cinema 4D software. We select 29 natural images that represent streets in train station, office room, among others. For each natural image, we create a virtual 3D scene and generate about 90 videos per scene. For each scene, we generate both normal and abnormal videos. For the entire dataset, we consider the following events as normal: walking, talking on the phone, walking while texting, standing, sitting, yelling, and talking with others. As abnormal events, we introduce 22 event types such as running, falling, fighting, or dancing. In order to obtain a supervised open set dataset, we organize the anomalous event types such that those included in the test set are different from those found in the training and validation sets. In the right side, we can observe examples of abnormal actions from each split. To increase the diversity of abnormal, we include multiple object categories such as people, cars, skateboards. Examples of these objects are illustrated in the left side. Unlike other datasets such as Avenue or Shanghai Tech, these objects can perform both normal and abnormal actions. To further increase the variety of the dataset, we include foggy and night scenes and fire and smoke as abnormal events. All anomalies in the dataset are annotated at the pixel level regardless of the split. We also provide the segmentation mask and the object label for each synthetic object from abnormal. The videos are generated at 30 fps with a minimum height of 720 pixels. We employ three different baselines for abnormal. The first one is an open-class open-set model, namely the background agnostic framework of Georgescu et al. The second one is a weakly supervised closed set model, the multiple instance learning framework of Sultani et al. And the last one is an action recognition framework, namely the times-formal model proposed by Bertasius et al. In this table, we present the baseline results on abnormal. As evaluation metrics, we use the frame level AUC, RBDC, and TBDC. Only the framework of Georgescu et al. Can perform anomaly localization. The action recognition framework of Bertasius et al. Obtained the best frame level micro AUC, while the method of Georgescu et al. Obtained the best localization performance. Next, we show that using data from abnormal can help a state-of-the-art method to improve its performance on real datasets. To overcome the distribution gap between abnormal and the real-world datasets, we propose to employ CycleGAN to translate simulated objects from abnormal to the Avenue or Shanghai Tech datasets. Translated objects from abnormal to Avenue or Shanghai Tech are illustrated in the left side. We improve the state-of-the-art multitask learning framework introduced by Georgescu et al. By adding the fifth task, which discriminates between normal and abnormal objects from abnormal. We train the model by jointly optimizing it on all five proxy tasks. In this table, we show our frame-level AUC scores for Avenue Shanghai Tech along with the state-of-the-art results. We observe that the objects from abnormal increase the performance of the framework even before closing the distribution gap. After closing the distribution gap, the obtained performance is significantly better than the performance of the original framework. In this work, we propose Abnormal, the first and only benchmark for supervised open-set anomaly detection, which enables the fair head-to-head comparison of open-set and closed-set models. It also can reduce the lack of training anomalies in real-world datasets, bringing significant improvement over the current state-of-the-art models. If you like our work, check out the Abnormal dataset using the link or the QR code. Thank you for watching.